We have a lot of military families in San Antonio, happy to have them, which is part of the reason USAA is headquartered here.
But unfortunately, there is a scam going around targeting USAA members. When one member was contacted, she emailed Barry Davis, and Eyewitness wants to know.
There are things out there that can protect you, but common sense is the best way.
The woman who got this email used her common sense. She didn't open it, and she called us.
There are hundreds, if not thousands, of phishing scams out there.
Paul Barry with USAA says it's nothing new. They've seen it before.
And they all have the same thing in mind, is to try to get you to give the bad guys information about your personal finances or passcodes or information to your financial accounts.
With hundreds of thousands of accounts, USAA members are likely targets. But the insurance giant says they, or really no institution, operates that way.
We will never ask for any of your personal information on the phone or online. So they should know that if somebody asks for that information, it is not USAA.
Cody Traxel owns Mainframe Computers and says the people who run these phishing scams are getting pretty elaborate.
They'll build whole websites that look exactly like your bank's website.
Traxler says take a good look at the sending address on the email. And most web browsers try to warn you.
Firefox is a web browser like Internet Explorer, and they have a pretty good database. So if you get a phishing email and you click on the link, it'll tell you, boom, this is a phishing website. We're not going to let you go to it.
But you have to be proactive about it, too. And most institutions like USAA have on-site personnel to help.
If you are a USAA member and you receive one of these phishing scams or a phone scam, call us first or report it to abuse@usaa.com.
Now, if you think someone is phishing or maybe trying to pull the old bait and switch on you about anything, report it to us. Give me a call, 377-8647, or send an email to ewtk@kens5.com. Barry Davis, Eyewitness Wants to Know.